Sup guys, this video is going to be all about GenPatcher. So, let's get started. What is GenPatcher? GenPatcher fixes up your Command & Conquer Generals and Zero Hour game installations so they work smoothly on Windows 10 and 11. It scans your game and settings and can apply more than 30 fixes to ensure your game will run stable. GenPatcher does not install your game for you, you will have to do that yourself. If you're trying to install the game, have a look at the links in the video description and they'll help you out. GenPatcher is also different from GenTool and GenLauncher. GenPatcher allows you to fix your game and install community-generated content. GenTool is an add-on that works directly with your game and adds features such as widescreen support and extended zoom for single player. And GenLauncher is a separate program that allows you to install, manage, and play multiple mods. So if you're into mods, look into GenLauncher. Don't worry, we'll cover that in a bit. But anyway, let's download GenPatcher and check it out in more detail. Now, in order to prevent Windows Threat Protection from interfering with GenPatcher, it's recommended to disable real-time protection. You don't have to do this, things might just work fine, but it could interfere and cause some problems when GenPatcher is trying to run or apply fixes. So I do recommend disabling it. Just hit the Windows key on your keyboard and type in security. Then click on Threat Protection, Manage Settings, and switch off Real-Time Protection. Next, go to leggy.cc/genpatcher and download the first link you see. Now extract the contents of the zip file somewhere like your desktop and run GenPatcher. The very first time GenPatcher starts, it will take a bit of time to fire up, so just sit tight and let it do its thing. And here we go, this is GenPatcher. For starters, you can select your language in the top right corner. These languages are for GenPatcher itself and not for your game installation. So you cannot just click Spanish and have the game be installed in Spanish. It's just for GenPatcher in here. But anyway, of course, you'll have a bright and shiny button almost blinding you saying apply fixes. So all you're gonna do is click it. Yes, it is just that simple. Just be patient and it will download and install all the files you need. When it's ready, it will ask you if you want to install GenTool. And yeah, okay, it's asking you, but it's like when your friend offers you free cookies. It's like, of course you're gonna say yes. Like, legit, there's no real reason you want to say no here. If you don't know what GenTool does, that's fine. Don't worry about it. Just click yes. You can Google it later. It's fine. And finally, for some of you, you'll see a third button here at the bottom allowing you to change your serial number. This is because EA created a batch of deluxe edition boxes that actually had invalid serial numbers on them, so you couldn't enter them into the official installer. However, GenPatcher, on the other hand, does accept these serial numbers. And surprisingly, the game doesn't break with them. So yeah, you can actually enter them here and everything will be fine. Just remember, this won't show for people who have the first decade or origin game installations. Now, let's go to the additional content tab, and this is where things get interesting, because there's a lot of nice stuff in here. So the first thing you'll see is that you can install a different control bar, which you can do if you want, of course, it's all optional. You can also install a GenLauncher for installing, maintaining, and playing mods. There are also some cool settings related to GenTool in here, such as playing in borderless full screen, or changing your single-player camera zoom height. You can also change your hotkey profile, with the option of showing the hotkeys on the icons themselves. And there's also a new and improved world builder. Finally, there's also the uncut or uncensored version for the German players in case they don't like the whole cyborg look and feel. All the content here has been made by a variety of community members and they're all awesome, let's be honest. I definitely recommend you check out the additional content tab and see all the stuff you might be interested in. Now let's have a look at the maps, because yes, GenPatcher has its own map pack, and currently there are over 100 maps. And the map pack is actually more likely to grow fatter over time as well. There still are active mappers out there making great new maps, so big shout out to those guys. Now the map pack is split up into four categories, mostly because everyone has different tastes, which is fine. So we have the skirmish and multiplayer maps, which can be played offline and online. The single player missions will only show in the unofficial map section when you play a skirmish. The multiplayer co-op mission maps will only work with other human teammates, and they will be labeled with a mission tag in the name. Then there are the AOD and Compstomp maps, which are maps where you and some mates play against the AI, and they will probably send something like 100 King Raptors, 50 Battlemasters, 10 Auroras, and the nuke all at once, and you gotta try and survive. It's something along those lines, so if you're into stuff like that, check it out. And then there are modded maps. Now, modded maps are maps that change some elements in the game. So these range from small changes, such as adding a capture the flag feature, or they can change everything by letting you build units and structures instantly. If you're into funky new experiences, check them out. Also, a quick note, if you play a mod map online, then all players have to restart their game afterwards. It's a bit annoying, but otherwise you might end up getting mismatches in the next games that you're gonna play. Finally, we have the no money maps. So, no money maps basically are maps where you don't have any base supplies. So, in most cases, these maps will have a few oil derricks instead. The most famous no money maps are, of course, the CXN maps, which are, in fact, also included in this map pack. And yeah, that concludes the maps. Remember, guys, that the maps will have their appropriate tag in the map name. So, like that, you know if a map is a mod map or no money map or whatever. Now, multiplayer. This is something where I think the game truly shines. Currently, there are three major platforms you can use to play online. I'm gonna give you my personal recommendations and the reasoning behind them. Now, I know some hardcore community members might disagree, but I don't know, I guess too bad. Yeah, I've been playing online since around 2004, so I know what I'm talking about. I've also used all three platforms extensively, but anyway, here's my recommendation. First is GameRanger. This is the platform I recommend for most people. The reason for it is because you can connect to most players right out of the box. There are also many players to play with, which kind of helps, and it's got its own server browser, so you can still watch YouTube videos while waiting for other players. Also, you'll hear a sound when a player joins your room, which is very useful, and you have your own friends list, you can add people, message people, and things like that. The biggest downside is that the protocol GameRanger uses is not the best when it comes to speed, so you'll have more laggy games. So you'll end up with like 1 second game freezes or like delayed reactions from your units. Another disadvantage is that this platform has the most cheaters on it, just letting you guys know. But considering all that, I still think it's the best place to start your online journey. Next is CNC Online, also known as Revora. This replaced the official EA Online servers and therefore suffers from the same problems that the EA servers had, which is the ability or inability to connect to other players. As a result, you'll probably want to do some port forwarding so you won't run into any problems. The latencies here are better than on GameRanger, so you will have less lag. There's also moderation going on, so they actually ban cheaters, which is also pretty nice. And it has its own buddy system and communicator thingy, so that's nice too. One of the problems of this platform, though, is that you need to keep your game running while you wait for players to join. Also, you won't hear any sounds when somebody joins your room. So you'll just have to sit there and pay attention until when your room is full so you can get started. This might sound like it's a strange nitpicking complaint, but honestly, if you host a 6-player match and you're waiting for maybe around 20 minutes for people to join, and you go AFK for a short bit, like 5 minutes, and you come back and you see that they've all been spamming you saying, dude, start the match, and then now they've all left and you have to restart, it can get very frustrating. So yeah. Radmin, the last platform, also suffers from this. But it also has a few other problems, such as it works via a LAN, which means when you host a game, it'll just say something like Joey's game. You don't actually have the ability to give the room a title. So people joining won't exactly know what you're planning to play. So maybe you're gonna be playing DEFCON 3v3, or DEFCON Free-for-All, or DEFCON 2v2v2. Who knows? And that's a little annoying, but that's about it. That being said, Radmin has, by far, the best latencies and the least amount of lag. It also works very well with connecting to other players, but it doesn't have a buddy system or something like that, so you'll have to keep in touch with other people through Discord or other means. Therefore, I would say, if you're a casual player and you're thinking about casually playing online, then go for GameRanger. If you know CNC Online and you prefer that network, then go for CNC Online. And if you're with a small group of friends, you just kind of want to play online, undisturbed, and just have some fun, then go with Radmin. Okay, there we go. Those are my recommendations. Oh my god. Anyway, let's continue. So regardless of the platform you use, you may have some trouble connecting to other players. That's why GenPatcher has this network optimizations toggle. It basically opens up your PC a little bit more to the outside world in order to let you connect to other players more easily. This thing is a toggle, so you can switch it on and off whenever you want. And after you switch it on, it probably is a good idea to restart your PC. Just putting that out there. This little switch can make a big difference, guys. So if you're having trouble connecting with other players, I'd suggest you give this a shot. The next option over here is to launch your game in a window when you're playing via Game Ranger. This is very nice for those of you who are trying to play in borderless full screen. And finally, we have a hide your IP address feature. So if you are live streaming your game, your IP doesn't get broadcasted to the world. Okay, next up, we have installation info. This just gives some useful data about your game. It also gives some nice shortcuts to your game's folders. So if you want to install a newly downloaded map, you can just click on the data folder for 0 hour and then extract your map in the maps folder. Easy. Finally, we have the about section. And if you've made it this far into the video, then congratulations. This is the end game credits. So big shout out to Tsetson for hosting a lot of the downloads, and a big shout out to the testers and translators for making this all possible as well. As you can see, this program took an insane amount of time to make. I created version 1 back in 2019, and this sucker, version 2, took around 2 years to make. So, you know, if you feel particularly generous and want to donate to the cause, I ain't gonna say no, but you know. Anyway, it's all optional, of course. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I'm just glad that a lot of people are using this and that a lot of people are still installing 0 hour to this day. But yeah, guys, if you have any questions, please check out the GenPatcher support page. The link is in the description. And if you can't find what you're looking for over there, then either join the Discord and ask over there or leave a comment down below and I will get back to you. That's gonna wrap up this video here. Goodbye, guys. See ya.